Okay, good morning everyone and welcome. It is Wednesday, January 5th, 2022, and I'm excited to have you here for Strength, Balance, and Core. 45 minutes of obviously working on our strength, balance, and core. And I'm Lisa Breezy, exercise physiologist, wellness heart coach, and founder of State of the Heart Fitness, and your source of fun and excitement this morning. So as I always say, make sure you listen to your body. Your body is your best coach. So if some of the exercises don't quite feel right to you, just modify, adjust, take a breather. Make sure you've had some water, a little bit something to eat. If you feel lightheaded, dizzy, that could be a sign of low blood sugar or a little bit dehydration. So make sure you listen to your body and honor it. All right? Okay, let's get the tunes cranked. We're gonna start off standing up, moving the body, getting the blood flowing. Okay, let's see. We're gonna start with a little of the Beatles. Two of Us. In which Doris gets her oats. Let's get this chair out of here. We're gonna just start marching it out. Singing along if you need to. On our way. Swinging those arms. Snapping those fingers if you want. On our way back home. So we want to get the heart pumping, the blood flowing, the smiles on our faces. Marching wide. Chair is bothering me. I gotta turn it around here. Let's get it out of our view. I admit, this song reminds me of my dad on his guitar. I don't know how many times in my growing up and in my adult life I see him sitting there playing the guitar. Oh, let's go ahead and tap those toes. Reach those arms. We're going home. We're going home. Everybody. You and I have memories. Na na na. Don't stretch us without a hand. And let's reach those arms up. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. over the heels, not over the toes. Okay? All right, back is tall. Squeeze those shoulder blades. Feel the upper back. Uh-huh. She's got it. Squeeze. Dance break. on that right leg. And we're going to bring that right leg out. Toes up. Slight bend to your supporting knee, okay? You're going to focus on a spot on the floor or the wall to keep that focus. Arms out. Now lift that leg. Lift. Lift. Strong core. Strong standing leg. Working those quads in that left leg. Woo! Keep that supporting knee slightly bent. No locked knees. Being good to those tendons and ligaments. Yes. Four more, then we take the leg to the side. One more, side. If you need to use a little balance, you know, putting your hand on the wall or a chair, but very lightly with those fingers. You can do that. Remember, whatever you need to do, listen to your body. Woo! Anybody feeling the standing leg? Holy moly. Good. Four more to the side and then back. Two, one, and press back. Woo! I'm going to show you the back. Side view. Press. Squeeze that glute. Squeeze. 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 Yes. Keep that standing leg slightly bent. Woo! Squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze, push that heel back. Little Diana Ross for you. I say four, three, two, one, woo! Dance it out.
Upside down, boy, you turn me inside out and round and round.
What we do to one side, we do to the other. Stand on that left leg. Right leg out, toes up. Back is tall, lift, lift, lift,
as if you give it me.
The slight bend to that supporting knee. Focus on a spot on the floor or the wall. Or if you need to use a little balance, touching the wall just lightly. Or chair upside down.
Boy, you turn me inside out and round and round.
Four more, then to the side. Two,
boy,
one, here we go. Side, side, side,
and
side.
Round and round.
Woo! Feel those hips, feel those joints. Standing leg.
Always with me. I'm crazy to think you're all mine. As long as the sun continues to shine, there's a place
to walk in your heart. Focus, Lisa. Press back,
side,
back,
and
back.
Round and
side
round.
View. Press,
side,
press. Squeeze that glute.
Boy,
squeeze, squeeze,
side,
squeeze. You guys are amazing.
Round and round.
Woo! Squeeze.
Instinctively, you give
feel
me
it.
The love that
we are looking for that burn, for that fatigue. We overload those muscles so they adapt and increase their strength. Four. Back heel, Venmo session in there, which has thrown my body up, but feels good to be back moving. Movement equals life. Yes, it's what saves us all. Woo! All that circulation, all that oxygen to the tissues, getting rid of the toxins. Yes, breathing deep, life is good. Woo, four more. Four, three, yes, two. We're gonna hold it here, hold little presses. Press, 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 press. Anybody feeling those legs? Oh yeah, four, three, two, hold. And give a little kick. Woo, cause I'm 50 and I'm, what did she say? And I'm fit, whatever. And I can stretch and kick. All right, what we do to one side, we do to the other. This is bothering me. I'm just gonna move this a little bit further. There we go, I don't know what. All right, big step forward. Left foot, back foot, back heel is off the ground on your toes. Arms out. Make sure your form is such that when you come down, the front knee is right over the heel, not over the toes. Protect those knees. Okay? Proper form, so incredibly important to keep proper alignment, biomechanics, so that we keep that body injury free. Yes, good. Rotate. Remember, working those obliques of that abdomen as we rotate. Woo! Back foot is far enough back so that knee is directly under the hip. Good. Woo! Four more, three, two, and hold. Little presses, press, 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 press. Four, three, two, and one, hold. Dance it out. Woo! You don't have to do it. On the floor or on the wall ahead of you. Oh, there's our cat. We already played this one because that went out of order, remember? I know you're like, well, we could play it again. Yeah, we could. But we'll go on to the next one. All right, holding. Now, if you can, a little bit more challenge, I want you to sit down and do a one-legged squat and hold. Now, you can bring those arms out. Changes the center of gravity when we bring them up, makes it a little bit more challenging. So you find your spot. Yes, and hold. Hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Yes, shake it out. Clowns to the right, jokers to the left. Is that what he said? It's appropriate for this class or our team members here, right? right?
Clowns to the left.
All right, team. Left heel to the ankle, or up to the calf, or up to the knee, or into the inner thigh. Open up this knee, arms out, slight bend to your standing leg, hold. You might be feeling that ankle constantly adjusting. So in our joints are what we call proprioceptors. Those are the nerve endings that are constantly measuring where we are in space. Those proprioceptors send messages up to the brain. The brain is constantly calculating, and in nanoseconds, lightning speed, sending signals to those muscles, tendons, and ligaments around so that we can maintain our balance. It's a miracle, I tell you. Our whole body's a freaking miracle. Everything. Let's bring those arms up if we can. Palms facing each other. Reach up. Spread those fingers. Drop those shoulders. And hold. Keep that standing leg slightly bent. And then let's see if we can squat down and hold. Feel it. Remember, where do you want to put your arms? No judgment of where you are. Don't get frustrated with yourself. Be gentle, be kind, be compassionate. Your body's doing the best it can for what we've thrown at it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Dance it out. How are we feeling out there? Thumbs up. Let's go ahead and let's do our toe taps. Left foot. Now our focus is to bring those toes up. We want to work the shins, the tibialis anterior muscle. So we are not focusing on pushing down, which we've got gravity working for us. We're working on bringing it up. Yes, keep it going. And these muscles, as well as our calves, are important for ankle strength, okay? And balance. All right, let's take it to the outside. Bring those toes up.
Good day, sunshine.
Woo! Uh-huh. Who knew tapping their toes could be so challenging, right? Take it to the inside. Bring those toes up. Oh, who's feeling it? Yes, feeling that burn, right? That's change happening. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whoa. Rotate. On your toes. Little ankle circles. And the other direction. And shake it out. What we do to one side, we do to the other. Here we go. Tap those toes. Bring those toes up. Work that tibialis anterior. It's all right. Now, if you haven't been doing these exercises regularly, take it to the outside. You might be a little bit sore tomorrow. Wonderful memories of today's class. Muscle soreness the next day is common. And it's part of the strengthening process. When we do any type of strength training, whether it's using our body weight, exercise bands, take it to the inside. Dumbbells, machines, exercise balls. Our goal is to overload the muscles, and what ends up happening is we get little micro tears in the muscle tissue, and then we give them 24 hours to rest and repair, and they repair at the stronger bond. Isn't that exciting? Yes. 4, 3, 2, and one. Here we go. Rotate that ankle on those toes. And the other direction. Feel alright. Alright, team. Time for some curtsy lunges or skaters. You can do one or the other. You can do both. Come to the right side of your mat. Curtsy lunge. Big step, curtsy. Big step, curtsy. Okay? And make it dramatic. Yes. And so you're getting a big round of applause, standing applause on Broadway. Curtsy lunges, working those glutes, working those thighs. If any of you want to change it to skaters, similar movement, just a little bit faster. Think of a speed skater. Whatever you prefer. Woo! One more minute here of curtsy lunges or skaters with enthusiasm. Woo! Who's feeling warm, strong, amazing? You guys are all amazing. You showed up today. You showed up for yourself. You showed up for each other. You're showing up for your body. And your body is saying, thank you so much for taking care of me. Woo! Yes. This body is the only one we get in this life. It is our stage to shine our light into the world, right? We gotta take care of it and honor it. 10 more seconds, team. Woo! Dance it out. Come on. Come on. All right. We're gonna make our way to the floor, and we're gonna do some push-ups, either on our knees or on our toes. Another option is if you're not quite ready for knees, you can do them against the wall or your desk or whatever. All right, but if you want to join me on the floor, let's do it. Stronger leg forward. Brace yourself, bring the back knee down. All right, knees or toes, we're going to do a set of 15 push-ups. Upper body strength with enthusiasm. Who loves push-ups? We all do. Okay, so if you're on your knees, you want to make sure that your hips are dropped down. We're not like this. Okay? Straight line, shoulders, hips, knees. If you want to come to your toes, you can do that too. No judgment with wherever you are. You are where you are. Love it. Be there. All right, everybody, get ready. We're going to inhale down, exhale, push up. Hands are a little wider than shoulders. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Here we go. Inhale. 1, down, 2, down, 3, down, 4, down, 5, down, 6. You're having fun. 7, down, 8, down, 9, down, 10, down, 11. Woo! Down. 12, down, 13, down, 14. Hold it here. Hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7. Do your best, whatever your best is. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whoa. Sit back into child's pose. Reach those arms forward. You guys are fantastic. Woo. Did we feel that? Big stretch. Feel your heart beating. Say thank you to it. All right, we're going to come up. We're going to work into our core, everybody. Let's go ahead. We're going to do a plank. Okay? You've got different options here. You can either come down onto your forearms and do them on your knees so that your abs are strong. Or you can come to your toes and hold. But if you sink your lower back, you're not going to feel it. You're going to feel in your lower back. I want you to bring those hips up so you feel those abs. From here, you can also alternate, lifting one leg or the other, or another option on your hands or toes, and just bring doing mountain climbers, we're going to do 1 minute of whatever version, okay? I know. Get your mind around it. You can do this. We can do hard things. Use your breath. It's your power. Inhale through that nose. Exhale through the nose of the mouth. Get ready. Your position. Here we go. Whatever it is for you. 1 minute. You got it. Roy says you got it. Who's going to doubt Roy Orbison? Yes. Use your breath. Woo! This should be challenging, whatever version you're doing. Mentally tough as well as physically strong. Come on, you can do it. Yes. We need to challenge ourselves, to change ourselves. You got 30 more seconds, whatever version. Stay with me, you guys are freaking phenomenal. Woo! You got it. Anything you need, you got it. Anything at all, you got it. You come for my singing, 10 more seconds. Woo! 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job, everybody. Sit back. Child's pose for a moment. Oh yeah. Woo. So why is it important to strengthen our core? What is our core? It's our abdominals, it's our glutes, it's our paraspinal muscles. They are our body's foundation. To build a home that's going to stand the test of time, you got to build a strong core. All right, let's go ahead. We're going to do some supermans. Work the paraspinal muscles, the glutes, a little bit of the back of the legs. So come down onto your belly, and let's take those arms out in front of us. Thumbs up. You're going to lift that left arm and right leg, and hold. Hold. Breathe. Always breathe. No holding your breath in these positions. Inhale through that nose, exhale through the nose of the mouth. Hold. Hold. 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it down. Other side, right arm, left leg. Lift up and hold. Woo! Remember, do what you can, but I want you to be honest with yourself. You gotta be honest with yourself. Can you challenge yourself a little bit more? Do not give up on yourself. Keep going. Breathe. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! All right. How we feeling out there, team? Thumbs up. Oh my God, never been better, Lisa. Thank you for asking. My pleasure. All right. We're going to add on to that one. We're going to try both arms, both legs. If this feels like too much, it's just not working for you, you can go to the opposite arm, opposite leg, and sing Lay Down Sally while you're doing it. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's lift up and hold and breathe. You can drop your head down or look up, whatever feels right to you. Hold. Breathe. Working those paraspinal muscles in the back. Working those glutes. Lift up a little higher if you can. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Make a little pillow with your arm. Rest your head. Relax and breathe. You can just take your heels. Roll them side to side. Loosen up the lower back a little bit. Everybody. Lay down, Sally. Ooh. All right, team. We're going to take our hands right underneath our shoulders. Point your toes. Keep those elbows close. And we're just going to do some work our triceps a little, pushing ourselves up and then down. Keep the elbows close and lift up. And down. Try and keep those shoulders away from your ears. Lifting up. We're going to do 10 of these. Keep
Keep those elbows right next to your rib cage. Four and down. Five and down. Feel the back of those arms. Six and down. Remember, you're having fun. Seven and down. We're so glad we showed up today. Eight and down. Good. Nine and down. And last one. Up. Four, three, two, and one. Fantastic job. Let's come up to our hands and our knees. Woo! Sit back one more time in child's pose. Big stretch. So it's always important after we do any type of strength training that we want to stretch to lengthen those muscles, but we're not done yet. We're going to come onto our backs. Work a little bit more of our core, our abs. So come onto your back. And we're just going to start with some pelvic tilts, okay? Pelvic tilts, this is not a back bridge. What we want to do is just get in touch with our lower abdomen, our lower spine. And what we're going to do, you're going to start with the natural curvature of your spine. So the middle of your back just comes up off the floor a little bit. You can even take your hands to your belly. Take a deep breath in. Feel the belly expand. And as you exhale, I want you to draw the belly in without changing the curvature. You'll feel the abdominals contract. And then inhale, expand. And exhale, draw the belly in, feel the abdominals contract. Let's do one more. Exhale, draw it in and hold. Breathe. Okay, so now we're gonna go into the pelvic tilt. Same thing, you're gonna breathe in, but this time, as you exhale, you're gonna push the small of your back into the floor and you're just gonna lift your tailbone, contracting your abdominals. So just a rotation of the pelvis. Now inhale, arch the back, even exaggerate it. Exhale, push the small of the back in, bring the tailbone up, squeeze the abs. Inhale, expand, arch. Exhale, small of the back into the floor, roll the tailbone up. Inhale, expand, arch. Exhale, push the small, or the tailbone, sorry, tailbone up, small of the back in the floor. Let's do one more. Inhale, arch, and then exhale, roll it up, and squeeze and hold all night long. Good, and rest. Yes. All right, team. Now let's take those arms up, palms facing each other. We're going to lift those legs so you have a 90-degree bend in the knees and the hips. Back is flat on this one. As soon as you do that, you feel your abdominals contract. Arms up, we're gonna do dead bug. Okay, keep your head relaxed on the floor. Take that right arm over your head without touching the floor. Left leg straight up, and then slowly lower it, only to the point that you can keep your back flat. If your back starts to come up, that's your stop point. Make sure you feel those abs hold and breathe. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the nose or the mouth. Your breath is your power. Ooh, hold it, hold it. Good. And then from here, we're going to take a deep breath in and then exhale, bring that elbow to the knee. And then inhale, extend. Exhale, elbow to the knee. Inhale, extend. Exhale, in. In, keeping that back flat. Exhale, in. Inhale, out. Exhale, in. Let's do four more with enthusiasm. Woohoo! In. Out. Exhale, in. You got two more. Inhale, out. Exhale, in. One more. Exhale, in. Fantastic job. Arms up. Recenter yourself. Left arm comes over your head. Back is flat. Abs are strong. Right leg straight up. Slowly lower down. Find the spot where it's a challenge to keep your back flat and hold. Breathe. Do not hold your breath in these situations. Ooh. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Who's having fun out there? We're almost there, team. We're almost to our home stretch. Literally, our stretch at the end. Inhale out. Exhale in. Let's do four more. Keep that back flat. Come on. Be focused. Be mindful. Work with that beautiful body of yours. Come on. You got two more. Woo! And one. Fantastic job, everybody. Wow. Let's go ahead. Feet on the floor. Let's just bridge our back. Squeeze those glutes. And just hold it there for a moment. You can interlace your fingers underneath your lower back. Hold, hold, hold. Squeeze those glutes. Push those hips up a little bit more. Take some deep breaths. And slowly lower yourself down. You did it, team. We're going to stretch it out to finish it off. Let's bring those knees into our chest. Keep your eyes closed so we can tune into our amazing body. Tune into where you feel this and gently just rock side to side. Give yourself a little back massage. Fantastic job, everybody. Fantastic job. Now, if you weren't able to do certain exercises, that's totally okay. We just keep working, right? We don't compare ourselves to where anybody else is because we're all on our individual journeys, but we're here together, and together we can do great things. Together we lift each other up to a place that we couldn't go by ourselves. That's why we join in community, right? Okay, with those knees, just rotate your knees around in a circle. Massaging that lower back and reverse. Little Miss was all about community. She owned that piece of land in the San Ynez Valley, and she had the world come to her. The whole community, Long Canyon where she lived, all of the neighbors would come and visit her. Let's go ahead. And take those hands behind the knees, bring those legs up, straight up, bring the toes towards your nose, feel that stretch in the hamstrings and the calves, shoulders relaxed, eyes closed. Just feel that stretch and just honor your body. We've all been very, very hard on our bodies in this lifetime. We've just taken for granted how resilient and miraculous it is. And because of that, we've used it and abused it. We've fed it food that really is actually toxic to our cells, but our body just keeps going until it doesn't. Until it finally says, I can't do this anymore. We need to change. Good. Hug the knees into the chest. And then with your left hand, bring the legs down to the left side for a little torso twist. Take your right arm out onto the floor, perpendicular from your body, shoulder blades flat, turn your head over the right shoulder as you feel a little spinal twist. Breathe deep and slow, nourishing breaths. Letting your body know that you're there for it. As you know, if you've heard me talk about this cancer journey, that it has just opened me up so much to really being loving to myself and to my body and to all that it does for me every day. Let's go ahead and take those legs to the other side. Shoulder blades flat, take that left arm perpendicular from your body. Turn your head over the left shoulder. You could, with your right hand, just assist on that knee. Feel that spinal twist. Breathe deep and slow. Deep breath in. Exhale. I want you to hug those knees back into the chest. And then we're going to rock and roll up and down our spine. And we're going to come to a seated position. Their legs crossed for a moment. And let's just take our hands to our heart. Our back is tall. Shoulders down, away from our ears. Bow the chin down. Close your eyes. Feel your spine. Feel the muscles, the paraspinal muscles running up and down your spine, holding you upright. Drawing your shoulder blades together. Let's just take this moment to bless and thank our heart for being literally the pulse of our life, but also our emotional heart that allows us to feel. A lot of times we don't want to feel the not so good things, but here's the thing, if we don't feel those, we don't feel the joy. All on the same spectrum, the flow, the wave of life. And let's bless our spiritual heart that recognizes that we are all one. And that what we do to ourselves, we do to each other. What we do to ourselves and each other, we do to the planet. And that when we heal our heart, in other words, healing ourselves from the belief that we are separate from everyone and everything, and recognizing that we are one with everything. When we heal our heart, we heal the world. Let's take this energy into the world today, and let's make it a better place for you, for me, and the entire human race. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me for Strength, Balance, and Core. It was my absolute pleasure. I hope you got something out of it. I hope you'll take it out into the world today in whatever way and give your unique light to the world. All right, I appreciate any feedback, the good, the bad, the ugly. After our recording, you can stay on for a little chat if you want. Thank you for those of you who have donated. I appreciate you all, and hopefully I'll see you on Friday for Stretch and Relax. All right, everybody, have a great day. Thank you for being here. Bye.